Black history is everybody's history. Mm-hmm. And I'm getting really tiffed at the fact that, you know, when you say Black history is controversial, it shouldn't be. It should not be. It is history. If you're not teaching to the demographics of the students that you're doing in, if they cannot see a reflection to engage in that, then you're doing it wrong. The standard says that you can teach Thomas Jefferson or whatever it said. And if you're going to teach Thomas Jefferson, then you're going to teach Sally Hemings. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You're going to teach that he enslaved people, because you are teaching Thomas Jefferson or whatever. I think the lesson for me is not necessarily thinking of what Black history I'm going to bring into the classroom, but what history I'm going to bring into the classroom, and being intentional that you're being inclusive with your choices. The reason that I think I focus on Black history is my personal love of the histories and the stories. I love the narrative, or I love the story of the underdog. That person that is not expected to win, that win. And we're not even talking about race. We're just talking about that. That's the stories that I'm drawn to. Yeah. So when we talk about Black history, we know that that encompasses a lot of our narrative. That's not all of our narrative, but that does come up as a lot of it. I start each semester with each course with a conceptual lens, with a focus. And that will help me choose which topics I'm going to bring to light. So for this semester, for civics, I'm using movement. For economics, this semester, my theme is labor. So for me personally, that helps to drive where I'm going to take my class. And with those themes, you're definitely going to bring in topics of Black history. So I was like, okay, then I'm going to have to find material that they are connected to. I like the education project. I love the history that they present, more inclusive history. The Library of Congress, accessing their website and always going to the primary source, because that will help alleviate that pushback. Because if anybody is going to say anything, it's like, well, I'm not making up this history. Yeah. When I initially got the pushback, they was like, well, all she's teaching is Black history. I was like, I don't go home and make up these facts and then spout them out the next day.
Right.
This is what the standard says. This is the evidence in history. And this is how I'm choosing to teach this.
Yeah.
So if you're going to let me be the teacher, then let me be the teacher. It is hard work. It does take a lot of time. But if you're going to be a teacher and you're going to be in front of the class, then do it. And I try to give my kids 100% every day, which my 100% doesn't always look fantastic, but I'm going to go in and do the best that I can on that day.